you very much, Mr. Burrow. President, and to the governor of this great state, to the mayor, to the governor of the mayor. Members of the dais, would you give me leave just for a moment before I talk to God to just mention one or two of the persons who have contributed so substantially to this project and who did not yet today? I'm thinking of the eminent former assemblyman from the 57th Assembly District, the Honorable Roger Green.
Who? Roger Green.
Roger was a prime mover from the beginning. And then, of course, so that I might sustain domestic tranquility, another who have contributed so significantly to my family, my life, Dr. Karen's new daughter, and my daughter's Let us pray. O God, we gather here on this 11th day of March, 2010, with humble gratitude and buoyant hope. We're grateful, profoundly so, for the vision and the visionaries, Mr. Bruce Wagner and family, officials, artists, athletes, architects, engineers, contractors, workers, all, community and union leaders. We are grateful for the genius of the human mind, which can concretize the intangible substance of dreams and visions into magnificent structures of super grandeur, which can visualize transforming this long neglected rodent infest, garbage thrown stereotypy into modern oases of splendid residential and commercial dwellings, a state of the art health facility, an intergenerational place for seniors and youth and children gather to share their unique life experiences, a world-class arena where artists and athletes can display their skills to the enjoyment of all, which brings health and healing. For you have said, O Lord, that a merry heart doeth good like medicine. And in all of this construction, there is space for green trees and grass and shrubbery and blooming flowers. Yes, we're grateful, but we are hopeful too. That our vision and our labor will bring a better life for Brooklyn, New York, and even beyond. I call heaven and earth to witness against us this day. If our labor does not fully actualize the vision, which is not only about constructions of sticks and stones and steel and material stuff, but more importantly, vision which enhances the quality of life of all, especially for those who occupy the bottom of our social ladder. If at least some of the downtrodden are not lifted up, if some of the excluded are not included, we will have failed unaccountably the vision of Mr. Bruce Wagner and others. Vision, not only will we have failed, but we will have misused the people's resources, and we will have angered the God we claim to serve. For the Bible teaches God is identified with the least in society, and when we reject the least, we reject God. And when we will reject the least, we will not enjoy the fruit of our labor, nor even the wealth that we already possess. And generations yet unborn will rise up and curse this project. But our hope is that the vision of a new day of peace and prosperity, a new day of health and unity, will be enjoyed by all. And then we will gain the favor of God, and our children will cherish our memories. In addition, oh Lord, we are hope that reconciliation will be consummated. That those who oppose this project, and even now, folks, will be drawn into the circle and come to share and to see the benefits that this project can provide for all the people. And finally, we pray for our elected officials here today. We pray for our president, Mr. Mark Witt. We pray the honorable for president. We pray for the honorable mayor of this city, Michael Bloomberg. We pray for the honorable governor of this great state, our friend and our son, Governor David Patterson. We pray especially for him as he is besieged on every side during this severe testing time. We pray, oh God, that you will grant him the strength of his conviction to walk in the light as you give him to see the light, and to be bold to do the right as you give him to do the right. And give him the deep comfort in knowing that those of us who love him will be with him come what may. And so, Lord, we conclude with the words from the National Black Anthem. Lift every voice and sing, till earth and heaven ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies, let it resound loud as the rolling sea. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who hast brought us thus far on the way, lead us into the light. Keep us forever in the path, we pray, lest our feet stray from the places, our God, where we met thee. Lest our heart, drunk with the wine of the world, forget thee. Shadow beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God and true to our native land. In the name of our God, our Savior, amen.